other kitties, same Kerry, the vacuum tube witch. And today we're gonna do some work on the rattle caster. The neck is pretty dirty, I will have to clean it, I will replace the strings. Also, the electronic part needs some review, checking if everything is correct. So without further ado, let's get over to the bench. And here we are with the guitar. Gotta find that block to put under the neck. Not sure where I had it. So instead of it, I will use a box, just like this. So the first thing I would like to do on the guitar would be unwinding all the strings. Because I will work on the neck. And those strings are pretty dirty, so I will still have to take them off. In order to do that, I got a string crank. So let's just unwind them all. Not the easy way as proposed by Fran, but yeah, this is slightly some more work to do. Looks like I'll still have to cut them. looks like the lower E string is clamped. I will have to move the carriage. I will still have to move this because I will have to set the scale length. So now that's the last sound they are making. Some of them got very tangled and discombobulated. So I will polish at least some of those chrome-plated surfaces. But first of all, what I'd like to do would be cleaning the fretboard. I will do it by powering some paraffin oil, some Vaseline oil, I mean. Distributing it along the fretboard with a cloth. And let's give it some time to soak properly. This will also protect the rosewood, impregnate it, and all the time then the rosewood is getting the oil. I can clean the guitar and check the connections. Check all the potentiometers that will need to be cleaned. Check the pickup switch. Check the pickups themselves. So let's start with the pickups. Looks pretty nice in my book. There was one teeny tiny screw dislodged under the pickup. I wonder why. That's pretty weird and kinda dodgy. And then, yeah, one of them might have been might have fallen through. QC pass 0602. So this pickup might have been made in 2006. Leave it this way for the time being. Do the other ones. Meow. This one is blue. 0602. then I will use the chrome polishing compound to make those cars look almost like new. Also 0602. I will also use it on the frets. This is the truss rod knot. I hope I won't have to adjust it again, because I already did that. Oh, I forgot about the setting springs. So one of them is red, the other one is blue, and the third one is also red. And the third one would be the longest. I have to keep it in mind when taking apart the pickup switch assembly. And I will be doing it, because I already took a look at what's happening in this guitar, and there's some discombobulation going on here. I would like to correct the soldering on that one, and some polishing as well. This is much better. and the humbucker that clearly has traces of rust on it. The cores on the humbucker are flush with the plastic, with the bobbin. Makes it a little bit harder to clean them. On the single coil pickups they protrude, and on the humbucker they are just flush with the bobbin. Yeah, it looks a lot better. Might also clean the bridge just a little bit. I don't want to go all the way and have to redo all the scale length settings on the bridge. That would take a lot of, that would take a mighty lot of time. But I'd like to give it some shine. And also, then the things I am doing on those guitars, they are not necessarily how it should be done. This is my very first guitar in my life, and I'm just learning as I go. The volume and tone knobs, so it will be time to unscrew those potentiometers, and then I will turn the guitar around. And I will also replace the machine heads. That's one of the mission objectives I have for this guitar. By the way, the short screw, it might have been the one found here, covering the backside of the bridge. And let's see what's going on in the connections section. This is the first single coil, this is the humbucker, and this is the second single coil. Some pretty bad soldering joints on the switch. I don't like it at all. This is the output from the switch. I will redo those solder connections. Because it looks quite ugly, I will also put some potentiometer cleaning agent into those spots. The industry standard alpha potentiometers with 7mm thread, rather hard to identify the value on those parts. Then the cabling is very shitty, and I will replace it. Got some pretty nice vintage wire. Come here, you sucker. And use the forceps, Curry. Use the forceps. It looks like the switch is double the pole from what I'm seeing on the printed circuit board. It's pretty nice that they used shielded cables for the connections. I thought it would be worse. Then the whole cavity could have been shielded. I might do it in the future as one of my mods. But I don't think I will do it. Just yet. This solder connection looks very ugly. By pinching it with the forceps, I create a heat sink, preventing the damage to the insulation. And now I can use the blue as the ground. Or maybe I should use a solid wire. Creating something like a ground bus in an amplifier. So on this end I would connect the input cables, and on this end I would connect the ground going further to the potentiometers. One of them here, one of them here. Connecting the shields. Let's refresh signal connections as well, because they don't look too good. I will test the positions on the switch with a meter. The leftmost should be the single coil. So this is the way I should put the pickup switch this way, because otherwise I would have the positions reversed. So it will be time to connect the volume potentiometer. The wiper goes to the output, to the quarter inch jack. I will redo this connection. This looks kinda dodgy as well, and I will also redo this one. And that would be the signal and the ground. I'll attach the pickup switch in place so that I have everything mechanically fixed for the time being. find the volume switch. This is the signal input, also goes to the tone potentiometer. This one I will have to put on the ground. Gotta attach it. Also the signal connection. And I will also do the tone potentiometer. For the sake of reliability, in case the wiper loses contact with the resistive path, I will also connect the end. And just a teeny tiny squirt of potentiometer cleaning agent into the tone pot and also into the volume pot. Time to attach them. And do the ground connection. Using the pliers to hold the wire. and then just strip the signal lead and solder it in place to the volume pot, and finally it will be time to check the output socket. And now let's check the socket. Not my favorite kind. But it will do. Soldered nicely in place. It is time to put back the cover and go back to doing work on the neck and also on the machine heads. Might polish this one. Not bad. So let's do some work on the fretboard. Some more oil. And let's clean some gunk out of here. It appears way cleaner. You might consider it pretty boring stuff, but it's very relaxing to do. Also worth noting is that the most grime you find right next to the frets where there are some hard to access spaces, nooks and crannies. And I will also try to polish the frets themselves. They look a lot better now. After cleaning the fretboard, they look way better and shinier, but looks like it's still not there. I've got this little slotted piece of cardboard covering the fretboard around the fret, and I will use it when polishing the fret. But I need some extra precision here. That's how I, when I watched Xandip 77 do that, he did it with a Dremel tool. I will do it with a cloth and do it all by hand. Xantip used a metal piece, which has its advantage of not being polished away. That's how you learn. You go along and make mistakes. This fret could use some sanding. That's pretty. It got some dents. Yeah, the frets that I just polished, they are shiny like cojones del perro, and the ones I haven't, they are pretty mate, so it looks like then the guitar is going places. And that's just six more to go. And that's just free. Then the cover almost got worn through. I'm gonna throw it away after this job. And time for the last fret. Number 24. Pretty nice. That's a lot better. Time for me to wash my hands. One moment, please. And I'm back. And what I'm gonna do now is replacing the machine heads on the guitar, because most of them are pretty rusty, not looking good anymore with the key number 11. Now the number 10 would be better. Let's rotate the guitar, turn it around. I won't be touching that one because this is the one that was missing and I replaced it. And those machine heads are attached with screws on the back side of the bridge. So in order to take them out, we will have to remove those screws. They look pretty ugly and rusty. That's why I would like to replace them. And since the one that was missing came in a second-hand set of those machine heads, I've got the replacements right here. On the other hand, some of those screws, they looked pretty scuffed, and I would like to replace them with good-looking screws that I found on my guitar. So, we are just making a pretty nice looking guitar out of two sets of machine heads that look mediocre at best. And I will check those screws and choose the best. This one looks okay. This one meh. So, okay. Yeah, pretty scuffed. And this one is also pretty scuffed. put those screws in place without tightening them. And then I will tighten them. Yeah, this one I will also replace the nut because it's pretty scuffed as well. First, let me remove the remainder of the string. And let's continue with the rest of the machine heads. Now it's time to tighten the screw on the opposite side. and tighten the main ones. And that would be probably it for this episode, because restringing and all the scale adjustments, that's gonna take some time. Let's do it in another episode. Put on the knobs on the potentiometers. So that's my guitar without the strings. Look at the fretboard, it looks way better than it used to. And maybe it will be time for some custom art on the soundboard. I will think about it. So that's one part of this little project of mine, the Rattlecaster Recombobulation project. And I just can't wait until I get it fully done with all the restringing and tuning. And then I hope it will sound better than it used to. See you next time. Bye.